Welcome to the Camping and Caravanning Club series of how-to videos. In this video compilation, we're going to share simple, practical tips and advice to help you keep your caravan or motorhome in tip-top condition while it's laid up for these winter months. From maintaining your leisure battery to servicing a toilet cassette, we've got it covered.
A separate charger connected to the mains, either used at the unit or with the battery at home. These monitor the battery and only give a charge when it's needed. They are capable of at least three stages and could get close to full capacity of the battery.
As far as the motorhome itself is concerned, one of the main issues is low temperatures. If water is left inside when temperatures drop, it could freeze and expand, risking all sorts of damage. So you'll need to drain down all the systems. Start by opening all the taps. If you've got mixer taps, make sure they're in the central position so both the hot and cold water feeds will empty. And make sure all the water's out of the shower hose too. You'll probably need to check your handbook to find all the drain points, so make sure they're all open. Sometimes it's easier to park on ramps or a slope to make sure they're at the lowest point. Then you can run the pump for a while to clear out as much water as possible and switch it off when there's no more water coming out. You might like to install a drainage system like this one, which forces air through to blow out any remaining water. When you've finished, make sure the pump is off and leave the taps open over winter. You'll also need to make sure the waste system is clear and clean.
Clean out the water barrel and make sure that's all ready to go. I'm using a range of products from Clean Taps. Others are available, but now we need to fill the water system by closing the drain valve. Fit water inlet hose. Put waste container at outlet. Switch on water pump. Open service tap from inlet. Draw water through until it stops spluttering. It can take a while. Repeat on the cold side. Now we need to add the cleaning solution into the AquaRoll, which is 40 litres. Need to give that some time to dissolve. And need to draw the water through all the taps so the cleaning solution can get all the way around the system. Remember, the water heater holds about 10 litres of water. After the specified time, refill AquaRoll with fresh water. Draw this water through the system. Once you're happy the system is all clear, then drain the system down. To do this, switch off the water pump. Put your taps to the central position, open the drain valve and allow water to drain. When empty, run pump for a few seconds to expel any water within. Empty and dry water containers.
Once you've emptied the contents, open the slide flap and turn the knob open to open up the blades of the cassette, or you can go back to the spout. But the important thing is to fill it with some water that should be there, and this will enable you to rinse out the tank. When you close the tank and shake it around, don't be too enthusiastic because you don't want to damage the float mechanism that's in there. That indicates that the tank is full. Empty the cassette again and rinse it a couple of extra times for good measure. Close the blades and slider flap or return the cap when you return the cassette to its locker in the caravan.
Check the dosage instructions on your toilet chemicals and make sure you follow them. These chemicals are designed to break down the contents of the cassette and mask odours. Don't pour the chemical into the bowl because it can damage the rubber seals. You'll need to add it via the spout, then add a little water and gently agitate the cassette to mix things up. Some campers choose to add a pink rinsing chemical to the flush water to give a little extra pleasant fragrance.
Don't be tempted to use normal home toilet cleaning products on the plastic caravan and motorhome toilets. They are likely to damage them. Look for kits designed specifically for your type of chemical toilet. As well as cleaning, they should freshen and remove any lingering debris or odours from the cassette.
But it's best to keep a good airflow if you can. To prevent damp, open up the lockers so air can circulate from fixed vents, and fix covers on your fridge vents if they're provided.
If the vehicle is left unused for a long time, the tyres will be exposed to sunlight for long stretches. They may well age quicker. If you can, cover them, but it must be with a breathable fabric.
When your unit is clean like this one, you may notice some marks and a dull look to the finish on panels caused by oxidation of the surface, mainly due to sunlight. No amount of normal cleaning will remove these marks and bring back the shine. Polishing, using a product like Silky's Restore, will remove these oxides and minor marks from the surface. So using a specific product like this, ideally make sure the surface is cool to the touch. Work on a small area at a time in circles with a clean cloth from top to bottom, overlapping as you go. Avoid getting polish on rubber seals and textured surfaces. This polished surface should now last a full season if you follow the final waxing stage. Some polishes may have an element of surface protection. However, a separate wax will provide a barrier against oxidisation, last longer, and will keep the unit shiny. Apply in the same way as polish.
Some people like to cover their motorhome when they leave it for any length of time. If you decide to do this, you'll want to make sure your van is completely clean before you put the cover on, so the fabric doesn't drag any bits of grit over the surface and scratch it. For similar reasons, look for a cover that's a good fit, so it won't move in the winter winds. Also, try to find one that has a door opening, so you can get inside to check things occasionally. The commercial vehicles on which motorhomes are based are really designed to be used regularly, so ideally you should take your motorhome out for a decent run once a month or so, covering about 50 miles. But for most people that won't be practical, so check the handbook and see if there's anything that's recommended for a period of prolonged inactivity. It's likely to suggest things like making sure the fuel tank is full to prevent problems, increasing the strength of windscreen washer fluid to stop it freezing, and using chocks to hold the vehicle so you can release the handbrake and prevent the brake seizing.
If you found this video useful, be sure to check out others in our how-to series on our YouTube channel. Happy camping and caravanning.